Hello and welcome back. In this particular section, we're going to be building a dashboard that is a completely dynamic dashboard. First, we're going to build the dashboard for new business. That is, you can see here, new business, and we're going to build the dashboard something like this. So this is the completed version of dashboard as you can see on the screen. So I have used various elements like shapes, and I have used image as a background as you can see. And also I have used shapes for preparing this card. As you know that we have done similarly in our financial model here. So similarly I have created cards here as well using the same data. And there are backgrounds for charts. That is, the chart is prepared is transparent, but I have put a background by using shapes for all these four charts here. And I have the heading here using a shape. So this is very professional looking dashboard and it's not that difficult to prepare. Only caveat here is that it's not a dynamic dashboard, which you would have if you had used the pivot tables and pivot charts. But since the purpose of this dashboard is to present your data, that is financial modeling data, in a visual format as a supplementary document, so for that this dashboard would be sufficient. It is dynamic, so whenever there is any change here, for example if you change this to linear, and if you come here, you see changes is reflected. So that is taken care, but it doesn't have dynamic elements here. Like here, there are no clicks here where you can click here and anything will change, any element will change. It is not built that way. Basically, it's a supplementary document. And to build that kind of dashboard, it's a whole nother subject. As I mentioned, one of the ways to do that is to use pivot charts and pivot table based reports and analysis, but we are not into that currently. We are building a financial model using Excel formulas and function and other controls like form controls. Now let's run through these charts and how they are prepared, and then in the next lecture we'll be building them step by step. Now the first chart shows the monthly trend, so the heading is sales versus GP, GP percentage, NP percentage and monthly trend. It also shows the highest GP and lowest GP, highest NP and lowest NP, that is in terms of percentages. If you see, this particular visual is a combination of three column charts. So there are three column charts I have used and I have grouped them together to create this kind of visualization. And here the first chart shows the sales trend, that is the each particular column shows the sales throughout the year, that is Jan till December 19, and also the gross profit. So I have used the clustered column chart and put this gross profit series as a secondary series, and I'm showing like this. The second chart shows the gross profit percentage throughout the year, each month, and also I have used special technique to highlight the highest gross profit in entire year in particular month with a green bar. So the usual gross profit are light blue color like this, but whenever there is a highest profit in particular month throughout the year, it will be highlighted in green. And the lowest profit would be highlighted in red color like this. It shouldn't be red color. Ideally, it's not a bad sign or something. Red color is usually used for extreme circumstances. For example, suppose there is a gross loss instead of gross profit. There you can use dark red color like this, but you can always change it. And each month we had the highest gross profit. So lowest gross profit and highest gross profit you can usually see like here. And similarly, we have net profit distribution, that is throughout the year. And also there we are highlighting the highest net profit month and lowest net profit month in terms of percentage. So as I mentioned before, this is a combination of three column charts like this. Now here we have a unique chart. Of course, it's based on a column chart, cluster column chart. So second chart again is a separate chart and I have grouped them together. But the first chart is unique. It also uses line chart and up down bars to create this third series. If you work with the column charts or visualization, in clustered column chart, you can only show two series. There are only two series you can show, and first is the main series and second is the secondary. So if you see, collection and payments are using column charts, while the third column has been created using up-down bars, and that's also with a line chart. Don't worry, I'll show you this fantastic visualization technique when we build this chart step by step. Now below here, we have a column chart again showing the operating cash flow throughout the year, and you can see here also I have used this conditional formatting showing highest cash flow in entire year in which month. So for example, here we had the highest cash flow in month of December 19 and we had the lowest performance of minus 4,000 OCF in January. Obviously, since this is a new business, we knew that in earlier months, since we are offering credit also to our customers and we don't have 100% cash sales, we would have some cash flow, negative cash flow in a starting of our business, that is in month of January. But starting February, as you can see, we have improved a lot. And here also you can see there is a sales. This is a gray color bar, which is up down bar, and the blue color is for the collection, and the red color, it's not exactly red color, it's a light red color, and it shows the payment. So in January, of course, since we were starting the business, we had a negative cash outflow, that is minus 4, and payment was exceeding the collection. On the right side, we have another column chart, which is also a combination of three charts. As you can see, we have 1, 2, 3 charts. Here we are showing sales for entire year for each product. So we have 5 products, as you know, mobile phone, smart TV, home theater system, gadgets and accessories. So this first chart shows sales and gross profit. So highest sale is for accessories, and also the highest gross profit in terms of absolute value. And here we have a GP percentage chart. So since we haven't built our entire model for individual products, that is KPIs like GP and NP, we haven't built individually. But we can do that in our chart backup data, which based on which this chart is prepared. So I'll show you how to do that. It's not that difficult. So here the second chart, GP percentage chart, shows the GP percentage. And also here also I have applied the conditional formatting, like which product is the highest GP in the entire year. So obviously accessories has the highest GP percentage and home theater system has the lowest GP percentage. Now the third chart, again, similarly, just like GP percentage, it's for NP percentage. So here also highest profit, net profit I should say, is for the accessories, followed by mobile phones. But we had a losses, or almost like break even in case of gadgets and losses in case of smart TVs and home theater system. So that's also conditionally formatted. I will show you how to do this kind of conditional formatting when we build this chart step by step. Now the fourth chart and the last chart is a donut chart. This is the most simple chart we're going to prepare in this entire dashboard. And it's a simply sales distribution for entire year's sales for all the products. So it shows the percentage of each product's sales share. So it's a product sales share. Here we can see accessories has the highest sales in all products. So among all products, accessories counts for 40% of the sale, followed by smart TVs, 19%. Then 14% is shared by home theater system and mobile phones, and the lowest sales share is gadgets. So as I mentioned, this is the easiest chart to prepare. Only the formatting we need to do it manually, otherwise it's a straightforward chart to prepare. These are the cards as I explained before. It's a simple, the technique is same as we have used here when we prepared these cards here. Similarly, we have prepared here these cards. And there's a heading with the shape here. So heading, and there's a text inside, and background image, I'll show you where to get it. And this image will also be available in the resources section, so you can download it from there. So from next lecture onwards, we're going to prepare this entire dashboard step by step. I'll show you how to prepare this kind of data. That is, this data is for the charts, and we're going to start with this kind of data building first and then go on with the preparation of this charts and entire dashboard. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions or if you need any clarification, please let me know in the Q&A section below. Thank you.